We have been bringing to you the top Diwali picks from top brokerage houses. Today we have Angel Broking for you. Joining us today to discuss the fund is fund manager Mayuresh Joshi. He's here with us to take us through his Diwali top picks from Angel Broking. Mayuresh, I'm going to start off first with Bata. The stock obviously just a month back was trading close at about 860 odd levels and propelled now towards the 1,000 mark. But why is it exactly that you like this stock?
Afternoon, Devina. So I think we've been liking this stock for a length of time. But a large element in terms of the opportunity that the market size presents, 50 to 60,000 odd crores, 30 to 40% is unorganized, which gives a huge opportunity for organized players like Bata. The second biggest facet within this market space itself is it's growing at around 14-15%. Now, Bata already has a huge amount of retail stores within its ambit, and what it's probably embarking upon in terms of opening up 500 more stores over the next 3 to 4 years, I think that's going to be a huge value addition because as they enter into tier 2, tier 3 towns with GST rates which have got slashed below 1,000 rupees, below 500 rupees, I think it's going to be very, very competitive compared to local players. Again, I think in terms of the margin profile, men's and children's footwear account for 70-odd%, ladies' footwear is around 30-odd%. So they're planning to take that up with innovative products to 40-odd%. And those products are high-margin products. So again, any pressure points that we see, obviously, from all these efforts that they are taking on one hand is obviously going to get passed on through price hikes. And to that bit, again, I think the margins are protected. So I think we're expecting very strong top line growth, margin stabilizing and improving further, which gives a natural leverage on their balance sheet. And the balance sheet itself is very, very robust and strong. So return ratio is also expected to be strong. I think that's the entire premise for Bata.
Okay. Mayuresh, your next pick for this Diwali is Safari Industries. Is this more of a catch-up play to VIP Industries?
So I think VIP Argam is expected to do well. Generally, I think if you're looking at how the luggage industry is panning out, I think three organized players, VIP, you've got Samsonite and you've got Safari. Now again, a major chunk probably still stays with VIP at this point of time, but Safari again is bringing out innovative products, whether it's backpacks, ladies products, and even the travel bags that we are talking about. Now the entire model, whether it's VIP or Safari, I think it's all outsourcing at this point of time, which largely alleviates any kind of a capex. And that capex plans, once it's not there on the books, I think the free cash flow generation is far more robust. Yes, there are a couple of risk factors in terms of labor costs moving up and what the currency might do that can act as a headwind. But a large element of pass-through in terms of prices, though with a lag effect, obviously protects margin. So yes, I think Safari is the number two player. But again, I think the kind of products that they're bringing through, I think are very, very innovative at this point of time. And there is a huge value accretion at play here as well.
So what would the target be? What's the potential upside for Safari? Because it's not a very liquid stock if you go to see. The volumes for today are just about 3,500 shares.
No, it is. I think it's the volumes are a little bit thin, Devina, on that counter. But largely, I think if one accumulates on declines, and we've been liking this for a length of time. So this is not a new suggestion. This is probably coming at our end. But what we're really liking, again, from this point onwards, is that there is sufficient amount of value even after the run-up that we witnessed. So yes, I think we see potential of a reasonable upside on the stock even from the current level, but one really has to probably look at the stock in declines in a staggered way because yes, you're right, I think the volumes are a little bit thin.
All right, a price target there of 1,071 with a potential upside of 35% on Safari Industries. The next pick coming in from Angel Broking and Mayuresh this Diwali is an RBL bank with a 29% potential upside on the stock. Most of the banks of late have seen a recovery from the lows, RBL Bank being no different. Stock's currently trading at about 521. But what makes this one stand out versus its peers, Mayuresh?
So I think within the mid-cap universe, Devina, this again has been a stand-ranked outperformer. What you've probably seen in terms of the advances growth has remained extremely solid for this bank. And our own expectations is that this solid growth will keep on continuing. Now, in terms of the CASA ratio itself at 24.3%, you're going to see a gradual improvement happening thereof. But again, I think in terms of the products that they're probably looking at, maybe the cards business. So again, on the retail part of their business is where I think the growth is coming from. And though I think a large chunk of the private banks are chasing qualitative retail, I think RBL, because of its niche presence and the niche opportunities that it probably has, I think the advances growth should sustain. Secondly, I think the kind of NIMs that they've been posting in excess of 4%, that itself would start sustaining as well as CASA accretion keeps on building up over the next few quarters. And a large element in terms of the retail advances being far greater, and the kind of expectation that one really has from retail products, even contributing to the non-interest income portion, should be quite substantial from an earnings perspective. So I think capital adequacy, we probably believe asset quality pressures are not that evident, whether you're talking about the absolute number or even the ECL number in terms of GNPS or NPS. They should probably remain stable, putting credit costs under taps, and the return ratio should remain strong. So we believe that there is a huge value accretion that can still happen in RBL Bank over the next few quarters.
Okay, and the final pick from Angel Broking Stable is HDFC Bank. Mayuresh, can you take us through this one as well?
So yes, Sargam, I think we are being a little bit overrated on financials at this point of time. But again, I think like RBL Bank, I think a stupendous show by HDFC Bank, 24% advances growth, what you've probably seen in terms of the NII growth as well has been equally good at 20-odd% for the quarter gone by. NIMs have come down a tad bit, again, because of the cost of borrowing pressures going up, and you did see some amount of slippages as far as their CASA franchise was concerned. But again, I think overall, if you probably look at their CASA ratios at 43.5%, PCR stands at 70-odd%, you've got Tier 1 ratios at 15.8-odd%, asset quality has been solid throughout for the bank. Retail advances have been growing at a very fast clip. We still believe that advances growth can be in the tune of 22-24% odd percent. And the return ratios have been exceedingly strong. So 1.9% ROAs, you've probably got an 18%, 18.5% ROEs, which should sustain going forward. Extension of Aditya Puri a couple of days back also probably gives some amount of support that the stock probably looks at in terms of a stable management at the helm. So our own sense is that there will be a solid top line growth. The advances growth should be very, very solid. Asset quality pressures are not that evident on their balance sheet. And that itself gives us the confidence that a qualitative liability franchise and a healthy capitalization ratio that it possesses will give the desired returns that shareholders probably want and stable returns thereof.
All right, Mayuresh, thank you so much. We leave it at that.